about power transformer guys. Well, boys, transformer, I have posted and I used to inform the correct value of power transformer to be used together my amplifiers. But this is not that rigid, you know, this is something flexible. You can use the power transformer you have, the power you want, the power of transformer you find, the power of transformer, it's cheap, it's handy for you because it's easy. Well, you do not need to use exactly that power ratio I'm informing. If the amplifier is able to produce, let's say, 100 watts, you do not need to make it to produce 100 watts of audio. You can make it to produce half of that. So you can use a weak transformer and your power amplifier will not produce the full power if it will be using a weak transformer. But you must have in mind that the AC voltage must be around 30 volts alternated, because this will result in more or less approximately 42 volts multiplied by 1.41, that is same as increasing of 41% related the AC voltage. There's the resultant DC voltage after you make rectification and filtering. Be attention, what is more important to understand and to know, if you do not know, I think some guys, young guys, do not know, is that you cannot create or generate power. This is impossible. The amplifier, audio amplifier power, depends on the transformer power. So if your transformer is 100 watts, you will never produce more than 100 watts of audio power, because you're going to be creating energy, and this does not exist in our world, this kind of generation, creation of a magic energy. We have in our world is losses. If your transformer has 100 watts, you will never have 100 watts of power from it, because heat and losses. So audio amplifier, usually class AB or class B, usually it needs twice its power from the transformer. You know, if a transformer is 100 watts, half its power can be produced in audio. So 100 watts in the transformer, if you have a transformer of 100 watts, maximum power you're gonna have is 50 watts RMS. Repeating, if your power transformer is 100 watts or 100 VA, VA is volts multiplied by amperes, and volts multiplied by amperes is watts. So VA is equal watts. So if you have 100 watts power transformer and then you feed one single channel amplifier, it will produce maximum of 50 watts. Maybe 55, right, more or less, okay? Because the efficiency of the system, class AB amplifiers. Do not matter if you use 8 ohms, 4 ohms, 2 ohms, 1 ohm, you can do whatever you want. Related speakers, injecting high levels of audio into the input, using 6 volts preamplifier. You can saturate, you can do whatever you want. All you're gonna have is more distortion, terrible sound, and the power will continue to be around 50 watts RMS. A half of the power supply energy, the power supply can feed to the amplifier. So if you use this 100 watts transformer in one channel, it's 50 watts audio. maximum. You say, well, but I have already 50 watts in 8 ohms. Hey, Carlos, I will install 4 ohms in the power. What's going to happen? 50 watts. But, Carlos, now I will put 2 ohms. What power going to have? 50 watts. But, Carlos, now I will install 1 ohm speaker. Power increase, isn't it? No. 50 watts. Right? That's what happens. This is what happens in the real world, in the practice, into the laboratory, in the reality. If this 100 watts transformer gonna feed 2 channels, so you have 50 watts of power to be distributed in between these 2 channels, so each channel will be 50 watts RMS, 25 plus 25, maximum is 50. Well, Carlos, I will put 4 channels, 50 watts total. If you add all channels, 50 watts total. Right, this is you must take into your mind. Your power limit. And this does not depend on the speaker impedance. It's almost approximately, sometimes 60%. Approximately half of your power supply. So this is you must understand and take your decision related to the transformers you have, the transformers you want to buy. So you must decide based on the reality. The reality of Class AB amplifiers is 50% efficiency. It will drain 100 watts from the transformer to produce only 50 watts of audio. But Carlos, I will put 2 ohms. No problem, will continue to be 50 watts. But Carlos, I will put 5 volts into the power amplifier input. Yes, you're gonna have 50 watts with a lot of distortion, but you will continue to have 50 watts. That's it. Bye-bye.